Okay, my name is Noah Winter and this is a video of initial consultation health screening completed on the 28th of August
2021. Thank you. Today, just for your first initial consultation, we're going to do, just a little bit of paperwork. This is just to give us your basic information and give us a bit of an idea of where you are sitting health-wise and fitness-wise. So we probably won't be going through any exercises today.
Okay.
It will just be mainly paperwork, and if we have some time at the end, then I'll probably show you around the gym so you can get a bit acquainted with the equipment. Alright, so I will start with, these two forms, well there's only two forms. First is your fitness coach personal profile.
Yep.
Essentially, this is just some basic information. It's also going to give some basic health information. And the APSS, otherwise known as the Adult Pre-Exercise Screening System, this is going to be just really give us an idea of where you're sitting at fitness and health-wise. See if we need to make any referrals to any other health professionals.
Okay.
Alrighty. So, we shall start. I'll start with the fitness coach personal profile. So, I'll get your first and last name.
Yeah, it's Adrian. Surname is McLaughlin.
And your date of birth?
It's the 1st of January 1968.
1st. 1968. And your current occupation?
Accountant.
And today's date is the 28th. And I'll grab your address.
Is 1 Lakewood Avenue, Greenpoint.
Phone number?
Yeah, 0410504012.
An email address?
Yeah, it's adrian.mclaughlin@gmail.com.
gmail.com.
Mm-hmm.
And an emergency contact for that one?
Oh, yeah, probably my wife. It's Jackie.
And same last name?
Yeah.
And her emergency contact phone?
Yeah, it's 0410698476. Okay.
And it was just the postal address, so the postcode?
Yeah, it's 2251.
And obviously in New South Wales. Alright, so now we're just going to move on to some health and fitness orientated goals, what you'd like to succeed, and with working here with me. Alright, so the number one fitness goal you have in mind?
I've just got a poor diet. I'm just recently diagnosed with early signs of cardiovascular disease, so I just wanted to increase my general fitness, but I just don't know where to start.
Alright, so, you said lose a little bit of weight, right?
Yeah, to lose a bit of weight. Just increase my general fitness.
Do you have a time frame that you'd like to complete these goals with?
Not particularly. Probably the next, I'd like to see some improvement in the next 6 to 12 months. Yeah, just a gradual improvement, yeah.
Goals, maybe family-wise, family-related?
Probably just being more active with my family. I'm not looking at doing a marathon or anything like that, but just generally being more active and a bit more healthy. Been able to move around a lot more easily, yeah.
Excellent. Specific needs that you specific needs you might need to be successful. So some people might need constant reassurance or motivation.
I haven't thought about it, so not at this stage. No, not that I can think of.
You know, I know some people prefer to exercise in a quieter environment, stuff like that. So. So this is just a bit more about you. So, are you currently exercising?
Oh, that would be no.
Alright. So, any reasons for why not? And any history you may have of exercising?
No real exercise history. Just sort of, my job keeps me fairly busy, so yeah, I just time tends to be an issue sometimes.
Yeah. Is it a stressful job?
Can be quite stressful, yeah.
Have to ask this question. Are you or have you recently been pregnant?
That would be no.
No, good. Alright.
Last time I checked.
I would hope not. Alright. Have you had any serious medical concerns?
I have recently been diagnosed with early signs of cardiovascular disease.
Yeah. Are you taking any regular medications at the moment? That includes like health supplements, whether it be vitamins or...
No, only beer.
Yeah, only beer? Yes. I wish I could put that as one of the medications. None to this. Alright. So now this is just going to be a short health check. We're just going to get your resting heart rate, resting blood pressure, your waist girth, hip girth, waist to height ratio, and your BMI.
Okay.
So I'll start with the resting heart rate.
Yep.
So a few ways we can measure this. Most common ways are on the neck or in the, on the wrist. Most people find the wrist is a little bit more comfortable.
Yep.
It's just you have to put quite a bit of pressure on your neck to feel it. So whichever way is more comfortable for you, I'll get my watch ready. That comes out to 85 BPM. All right. So next is the blood pressure for automatic blood pressure machine here. Too tight?
Are you doing hips or?
Okay, we're going to start. We'll start with the waist. So, okay. Where is the thickest part of your waist?
Yep.
Down to the thickest part of your hips. Oh my God, just move that around. Excellent. That's 47.5 inches. I'll convert that from inches to centimeters. Thank you.
179.
1 to 1.6 ratio.
Okay.
So that's a little bit high, but it's something we can work towards bringing down.
Mm-hmm.
And next is the BMI. So what was your current weight?
105 kilos.
105 for. BMI comes out to 34.7, again, a little bit high, but it's something that we can bring down in the next few weeks, few months. So, alright, and on to the next page. Okay, so this is just some information about your lifestyle. So, how active is your job? There's a few options here. So, sedentary, light activity, or moderate activity?
Yeah, it'd be sedentary. Sedentary. I sit all day pretty much, yeah.
Yeah. And how active is your day?
Don't get up a lot. Probably maybe light activity, I suppose, for that. Yeah.
Maybe a bit of playing with the kids or whatever.
Maybe, yeah, after work, yeah.
Sleep. In the past month, how often have you been emotionally affected by your health?
Okay. All right.
So,
about once a week.
About once a week? So we're just going to tick the statements most accurately describes your diet at the moment. So do you feel that your diet is healthy, doesn't require changing? You feel that you are that there are a few changes that could be made, but overall it's all right? Or that your diet requires a number of changes and you're not sure where to start?
It would be the last one there. Yeah, we're going to need to get it sorted out.
Excellent. And this is just for an exercise plan. So, how much time can you commit to your exercise plan? So, how many days a week and how many minutes per session?
I'd like to probably 3 to 4, I suppose, times a week.
And how many minutes per session are we looking at for in those?
Maybe 30 minutes to an hour. 30, 60,
excellent. And what time of day do you prefer to exercise? Morning, midday, afternoon, evening?
I generally have a bit of time spare in the afternoon, so.
Afternoon? Let's skip that one. And what days will you train? So from Monday to Sunday, which days are you looking
at? I probably sit every second day during the week, so probably Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yeah, and maybe every second Tuesday, I'd say.
And this is just going to be some fitness activities that interest you. So, what is there anything in particular that you have an interest in?
Swimming or gym, I suppose.
Swimming, cycling. Obviously weights, so machines and free weights. Are you interested in both of those?
Yeah, I'd probably give them a go.
Stretching, running.
No running. Good.
Knees giving out.
Probably no running.
All right, all good. Any group exercise class or anything that you may
be? Yeah, I'd be open to looking at that. Interested in group classes.
Some of them can be quite high intensity. Some of them are sort of CrossFit and F1 type classes, but probably not something to start with, but something we can work into. And there are some. Not to say lower level, but a little bit more, less intense as well. So, all right, I'm going to open Anything else in particular? I know some people are interested in boxing or...
No, I'm sort of new to it, so I suppose I'm open to some new things, but yeah. Nothing in particular that strikes me that's been of interest.
Leave that one. And what intensity would you like to exercise at to start with?
Probably start low, I suppose. Yeah, so we don't want to go straight in high, especially with my,
sorry,
my recent diagnosis.
Yeah, I was going to say, particularly with the heart, you don't want to put too much stress on that straight away. So, and any fitness activities that really don't interest you, so really...
Probably with my size, probably not running.
Running?
Yeah, probably running's not real keen on that.
Now I should just get you to sign and put your full name for that one, just to make sure that all the information that I've been received is correct.
Yep.
And that you're happy with everything so far.
Yep.
There you
go.
Excellent, thank you. Alright, so now we shall move on to the adult pre-exercise screening system. So I'll start once again with your full name and date of birth.
Yeah, which is Adrian
McLaughlin. And date of birth was the 1st of the 1st, 1968.
Yeah.
And male. Okay, so there's 6 questions here I'll ask you. It's just
sure.
Going to be a basic yes or no.
Okay,
so has your medical practitioner ever told you that you have a heart condition or have you ever suffered a stroke?
Well, the brief reason of being diagnosed with a cardiovascular disease, yes.
Yes, yeah. Alright, do you ever experience unexplained pains or discomfort in your chest at rest or during physical activity?
Only very slight. That was the reasons for going to the doctor to find out my diagnosis.
Yes, fair enough. Do you ever feel faint, dizzy or lose balance during physical activity or exercise?
Yes, have done in the past.
Have you had an asthma attack requiring immediate medical attention at any time over the last 12 months?
No.
No. Excellent. If you have diabetes type 1 or 2, have you had trouble controlling your blood sugar levels or glucose in the past 3 months?
No.
No. Excellent. And do you have any other conditions that may require special consideration for your exercise?
Yes.
Yeah. Because you've answered yes to more than one of those 6 questions, I will be referring you to probably a cardiac specialist.
Yes.
Just to make sure that everything's going well with the cardiovascular disease, and that also to tick off that we can start a training program.
Mm-hmm.
So that just sort of covers everyone's bases there. So last question. Describe your current physical activity and exercise levels in a typical week. So just looking at frequency, so how many times a week would you be exercising in?
Maybe once or twice.
Once or twice. Yeah, I was going to say that does include with the kids.
Yeah.
That is, yeah. And how long do those sessions normally go for?
Maybe an hour, so yeah, probably an hour to 2 hours, so there's...
Yeah. Alright, and once again, I'm just, based on this small piece of information here.
Yep.
Just based on that, would you still regard your sessions, even with the kids, as light?
Looking at that, I'd say I'd be in the light category there.
Light?
Yeah.
Cool, yeah. Excellent. So now, once again, I'll just get you to sign and date this last piece of paper.
Yep.
The pen.
Okay.
Excellent. Alright, so I will go file these away in my cabinet, and for now, we shall go, I'll give you a tour around the gym.